Insulin resistance is at the heart of the metabolic syndrome. In fact, so much so that what we call the metabolic syndrome used to be called the insulin resistance syndrome. Let me take a moment and define insulin resistance. Every single chronic disease is in some way influenced by insulin resistance, where insulin resistance is either directly causing the disorder or it is facilitating the disorder. Insulin resistance is a disorder with really two parts. I like to invoke the analogy where insulin resistance is like a coin. If I were holding a coin in my hand and I say, this coin is insulin resistance, well, the coin has two sides. So too does insulin resistance. One part of insulin resistance is the actual resistance to the signal of insulin. Insulin is a peptide hormone made from the beta cells of the pancreas. You know that. And as it circulates in the blood, it will come and bind on receptors of every single cell of the body. That's one of the reasons insulin is so unique. As a peptide hormone, it is that every single cell of the body, from brain cells to bone cells, from lung cells to liver cells, and every cell in between, they all have insulin receptors. And so the receptor is essentially a doorway that is built for insulin to come and knock on. And insulin will knock on every door of every cell. So this is the insulin resistance part of it, though, where some of these cells aren't responding to insulin anymore, as well as they used to. They've become resistant to that knock. So once upon a time, insulin would come and knock on the door of the cell, let's say the liver cell, and the door, if you will, would open right up and liver would respond appropriately. It would do what insulin asked it to do. However, over time, due to insults that we will talk about next episode, the knock falls on deaf ears and the liver cell doesn't open the door all the time, or maybe it'll open it a crack. It doesn't actually do everything insulin wants it to do. That is the resistance part of insulin resistance. Now, please notice the deliberate use of language here. Not every cell becomes insulin resistant. This is not a universal phenomenon within the body. Some cells of the body fail to respond to insulin as effectively as they used to, or as sensitively as the response that you would expect. Now, we can flip that coin over, because there's another aspect of insulin resistance, and this is the part that is so totally overlooked. And that is that in every instance of insulin resistance, with one exception that we'll talk about at a future classroom, insulin levels will also be elevated in the blood. So if we are now going from the level of the cell to the level of the whole body, at the cell there was the selective insulin resistance. At the whole body level, this is manifested as an elevated insulin level. Insulin resistance and hyperinsulinemia, which is the technical term for elevated blood insulin, are inseparable. They will always occur together, just like two sides of a coin. You can't get rid of one side. They're always going to be part of that coin. So too is insulin resistance and hyperinsulinemia. Now, that hyperinsulinemia part is relevant because, remember, there are some cells that still respond to insulin as well as they used to, as well as they ever did. They're still insulin sensitive. So you have a handful of cells that are insulin resistant. So even though insulin levels are elevated, they're not responding that well to it, and so it generally is just a muted response anyway. However, the cells that are as insulin sensitive as ever are now overstimulated. There's too much response to the insulin because there's too much insulin relative to normal, healthy, insulin sensitive levels.